If we look across the early childhood literature, all studies, here's a list of things we can take to the bank. We can increase school readiness, kindergarten readiness. We can increase math and reading achievement all the way into adulthood, reduce special education placement, reduce retention in grade. The children in the Abecedarian Project who got the early childhood education were 4 times more likely to go to college and to graduate from college than the kids in the control group. And they went to college and graduated at the rate that the general population does, about 25%. And as adults at age 30 and 35, the kids who went through are more likely to have higher incomes and have jobs of higher prestige. They're more likely at age 30 and 35 to qualify as being well into middle class. They're also less likely to report marijuana use. They're less likely to be engaged in crime. We just published an article about two months ago in Science showing that the early childhood education resulted in a lowering of cardiometabolic risk, that is a lowering of resting blood pressure, diastolic and systolic. And when we figure in these returns on investment, this finding is so new that it's never been figured into any of the cost estimates. So lowering the risk for heart disease or stroke or the treatment, in addition to some of us having a vested interest in wanting that to work out, you know, that means there's going to be a bigger return on investment than has currently been estimated by the best economists to be in the range of about 3-to-1 to 7-to-1. Or put another way, Jim Heckman, who's a dear friend of mine, and we've shared all of our data with him, he says realistically early childhood can give you a rate of return that's somewhere in the 10-to-12% range.